This is See Her Dead, written by Rylie Dark, narrated by Maggie Schneider. Chapter 1. It was a beautiful night for a walk. After 3 days of nonstop rain, Eve Saldino couldn't wait to get some steps in. She jogged to the front door, shaking the leash. "Come on, Buster. Time to get some exercise." Buster, unfortunately, had always been allergic to the E-word. She listened for the tinkling of the bell on his collar that indicated he was on his way to her. Hearing nothing, she sighed and found him lying on his bed in the living room, stretching in the fading, blood-red sunset. "Oh, Buster," she said, nudging the bloodhound mix out of his bed. "Just a little walk. Just around the block?" He gazed up at her sadly, unwilling. This was how it always went. Sometimes she wondered why she'd fallen in love with him at the pound. All the other dogs had been yipping and wagging their tails, excited. He'd been lying in his dish of food, too tired to be bothered. "One walk. Please. 5 minutes at the most." She laced her fingers together, begging. Something must have lit a small fire under him because he raised his droopy body, let her clip on the leash, and followed her out the door. It was a cool evening as the rain had come through with a lingering cold front. Eve shivered as she walked, watching the lights in her upscale Dallas neighborhood flicker on as the sun sunk behind the trees. At first, Buster seemed energized, rushing out in front of her, but eventually he got stuck sniffing something and didn't want to continue. Eve tugged the leash. She'd never get any exercise at all if this continued. Her doctor wouldn't be happy. She needed it for her heart. "Okay, boy, let's keep at it." They took off again at a brisk pace, but once again, Buster started sniffing at the curb after a few steps. "Oh, come on, sweetie," she said to him, sighing. She probably should have left him at home, but whenever she stepped out the door, he whined. "I need this for my ticker." He just stared up at her with sad, uncomprehending eyes. "One more try?" she pleaded, tugging the leash. The floppy-eared dog took off as fast as his stubby legs could carry him, bounding forward until he reached the next driveway. Then it was nose to the ground just like before. All this starting and stopping, pulling on the leash, couldn't have been good for her back. At 60, it was easy to pull a muscle. Too easy. She was about to scold him again when a streetlight overhead blinked on, casting a sulfuric glow over the driveway. She noticed something glistening on the asphalt near the garage. Broken glass. "Oh, that's terrible," she said aloud, wondering if a neighborhood kid had thrown a ball in the window. She looked around, but the area was quiet. All the children who usually ran up and down the street, filling the air with their gleeful cries, were in their homes. I wonder if the homeowners even know. She stood there for a moment, wondering what to do. The woman who lived in this house had moved in only a month ago. She'd meant to come over with a casserole to welcome her to the neighborhood, but she hadn't seen her outside, except for the day that the moving truck pulled in. It was a young woman in her late 20s, possibly a workaholic, she assumed, since her car was never in the driveway during the day. Though she hadn't known why, she'd had the distinct impression that the woman wasn't interested in making friends. Buster sniffed the ground at her feet, then whimpered and tugged on the leash. "Oh, sure, now you want to go?" she muttered at him. Then she decided to walk up the drive and have a better look. Sure enough, the window to the garage door had been shattered. Carefully navigating around it and steering Buster clear of the mess, she peered inside, looking for the baseball that had done it, but it was too dark to see. What she could see was that the latch to open the door from the inside had been turned. Then she realized that the garage door was open an inch. Had someone gone in that way? Had someone broken in? She swallowed, alarmed. This was a safe neighborhood, a good one. They never had break-ins. For a moment, Eve didn't know what to do. Should she call the police? Was this really happening? Maybe one of the residents had lost their key. That was a more likely possibility. Yes, she told herself. She couldn't jump to conclusions. Calling the police on new neighbors would be a rash decision. She'd just knock on the door and make sure everything was all right. That way she could finally introduce herself. Hopefully, they wouldn't think she was being nosy.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.